So there's like I said, I'm trying to do something every week that's different and weird and new. And something that I don't think, at least we haven't done on this podcast. I don't know if they did it on the old one at any point. I want us to
Uh-oh.
pitch a Zelda film. And I want us to come to an agreement on which game it should be based off of, if any, actors, composers, and directors.
Oh my
I know. I
gosh.
want us to build the perfect Zelda film. So, I guess we should start off with which game should it be based off of? Let's.
None of them.
Okay, so you say none of them. Why?
Because the very best films, because there's always a fear with video game movies that's gonna suck, right? Like, that's always a fear. And usually it ends up sucking because it tries to follow a video game that wasn't designed to be in a film form. So I'd rather it be something that's more based on the world of Zelda than being based on an individual game, because there isn't enough story in those games to make it work. And I know that means you could fill in a lot of the gaps, but again, Zelda fans are fickle. They already have an idea of what happens in those gaps. So you kind of go off on something completely separate from the Zelda universe that's based in the Zelda universe. And uses some of the things from, like, the Triforce and, Master Sword, like, bring some of the traditions in, but don't base it on a game, man. I mean, I know that's going to build hype. It's also going to be bad.
Well, like, yeah, for example, if you want to see how it would, like, Ocarina of Time would work in a Zelda film, I referenced this a while ago. Look up The Hero of Time by B&B Finishes. There's like, it pretty much goes as you'd think a Zelda film would go. In terms of, well, you start out, you have like this dungeon, and then there's a montage of other dungeons, and it's like that's it's pretty much the formula for a Zelda game in a movie. And I agree with you. I don't think this should happen. Like, I'm thinking, like, in my head, you know, we see different characters develop. We see Ganondorf come to power, or his rise to tyranny or something, and
Now, I will say
yeah.
this. If they want, like, if we want this to be, like, canon, like, part of the main line of stuff, because, like, I guess, when you think, oh, something that's based in the world but completely separate, fans might not care as much. I could see that. Then it should be something that takes place during an era we know exists, but we don't know anything else about it. Whether, like, the imprisoning war. Or whatever happened with the Sheikah, and if they split up, and all, like, stuff that we do not have any details for that could easily be filled in with, like, a film or, like, a TV series, without necessarily infringing on anything else, as long as we know the general endpoint. Like, we might not know how the imprisoning war ends, but we know what exists after. So as long as however it ends can possibly lead to that existence, then we can basically be fine with it as
I
fans.
feel like they'd have to start off with an actual, if they wanted to build that kind of a universe, they'd
Yeah.
have to start off with a Zelda film with like the mainline characters in it before they did like a spin-off.
Yeah. And see, I think if they're doing the Zelda film, this is why I really like the separate from the Zelda series, but based on the world idea, because we almost get a new Link in every game. So if this is going to become a series, people are going to get connected to a certain character like Link. It's got to be a series of one character going on adventures. So, I mean, I guess they could just recast Link every single time.
Be like James
And if they
Bond.
really want, yeah, but, like, well, even James Bond, like, they have, like, one guy go for,
Yeah,
like,
no,
five or six
it'd be
films.
like, you know, Link for 1, 2, 3, and then the next one. But it'd have to make sense from a story point of view because at this point, yeah.
Like, in James Bond, it kind of sort of makes sense because 007 is just, it's not really the guy's
Yeah.
name. That's just, like, the agent name. So, like, it's kind of clever how they actually set that up where it could just keep working. Zelda is not really set up in that way outside of, I mean, story-wise it is. Like, there's the curse and there's all this stuff going on. Like, it makes sense at a video game level. I just don't think it would make sense on a
You'd have to
screen.
explain all of that. If you wanted to go with that
Yeah.
explanation, then you'd have to pretty much do Skyward Sword the film.
Yeah.
And
And I want something totally separate that's just based in the world. That's just really what I want. I mean, yeah, I just can't think of any other way to really go about it. Like, I can't think of any Zelda game that would make a good movie. Like, I could think of, oh, it's also cool that Ocarina of Time is a movie, or Twilight Princess, or Skyward Sword, A Link Between Worlds. Like, these sounds, oh, this would be awesome to win. And then I think about it, I'm like, it doesn't really sound that great as a movie.
I mean, like, I could see different points from those games being made into, like,
specific moments, I could see. You know, like, there was that, this didn't happen in the games, but there was that one fan short that had Sheik or Zelda talking to Link intimately during a moment in Ocarina of Time that never happened in the games, but totally fit into the universe.
Yeah.
And it was kind of a precursor to Zelda becoming Sheik. And it was just a beautifully crafted scene. There was a couple mistakes that would need to be cleaned up in a real release, but like that kind of stuff works in a short.
Yeah.
Like we're talking like a film, mm-hmm. right? Like not shorts. Like Nintendo does like Pikmin shorts and stuff.
Yeah. So it'd be like a full fledged movie, and I think they'd have to start from square one. It's kind of like
start over again and just use the series as like a reference point rather than like a guide.
Like, use Link, use Zelda, use Ganondorf and Sheik or Impa, and all those characters just don't adhere to a specific source material.
Yeah, like do your own thing with it, because I think that's the only way it's going to work. And I think that's the only way video game movies really work in general, is if they do their own thing with it. Just, the thing is, I really like the Super Mario Bros. Movie that totally did its own thing as well. But, like, don't go in that direction. And I guess that kind of gets into who's going to be the writers, who's going to be the actors. The director.
I think we're diametrically opposed on that Super Mario Bros. Film, but I'm not gonna go.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of people that hate it. I don't know why. I just,
as a kid, I liked
it's highly entertaining to me. I like the Zelda cartoon series too. Like, I wish that didn't end. I don't know. I don't know why they're entertaining to me. Like, it's not entertaining in the way like Game of Thrones is. Like, Game of Thrones is a whole new level. But I don't know. Anyways, are we kind of in agreement that it should just take place outside of the Zeldaverse,
be its own film, basically.
Yeah, like split off on its own timeline before everything else began. If that's the way fans want to think about it.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll work a little bit backwards then. Who would you like to see compose the music for the film? Like, I can think of a few right off the top of my head.
That's a very good question. I mean, part of me wants to say Koji Kondo, just because.
That's the easy answer, yeah.
That's the easy answer. He's done so many Nintendo stuff. He's proven he can do orchestral stuff, which you would obviously have in this film. Mm-hmm. This is where I have to sadly admit I don't follow the composers very much. Like, whoever did the Lord of the Rings music was brilliant. Mm-hmm. I don't know who it was, but it was brilliant. Like, that music just... Something like at that level... I don't know if it has to be that person or multiple people. I mean, you seem to obviously have a few people in mind. Like, who are you thinking about?
Well, off the top of my head, like, I'm thinking people like Michael Giacchino. What was the last movie that I saw? Oh, he did, the Doctor Strange soundtrack, which is phenomenal.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
The music in that was awesome.
You know, instinctively, one of my favorite composers of all time, just John Williams.
Okay.
I don't know if his style would fit with the Zelda film, though. He's very...
Yeah, it's just someone you personally like a lot.
Yeah, he's very brassy. He uses a lot of trumpets. I don't think that kind of
stuff... Yeah, that doesn't fit Zelda.
Yeah, it'd have to be, like, violins. Hey,
maybe it's Trumpet of Time we're making. Yeah.
and then I'm thinking, oh my gosh... Someone that would be... I'm going to try to remember... Get his name correct. He did the... I think Klaus Badelt. The guy that did... No. Who did the...
Ah. So the guy I'm thinking of for Lord of the Rings was Howard Shore.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm thinking...
I really loved his work. But see, that's also me thinking, like, that's a high fantasy. Yeah. Series.
Well, that's kind of like what I'm thinking along the lines of. And then, like, Klaus Badelt, he was the guy that did the first Pirates of the Caribbean film, or did some of that music.
Okay,
sure. And then Hans Zimmer would be really good, because those are very adventure
Hans Zimmer,
vibes in terms of music. Whatever, as far as I'm concerned, my only off limits, the person I never want to score that movie, or score any movie, well, that's not true, he did really good on the Deadpool film, is Junkie XL. I didn't really
like it. I didn't, his style really fit Deadpool.
Yeah, it fit Deadpool. I didn't really like it that much in Batman v Superman or Captain America Civil War. I wasn't a huge fan of that.
It just felt okay in those movies.
Yeah.
Maybe safe, mm-hmm. I guess, is the way to put it. Did we mention him, John Williams?
Yeah, but he's very Trumpety.
He is. He is very Trumpety. I just really love the work he's done.
I know.
His movie list for composing is amazing.
But
yeah, again, you're right. I keep thinking of his music. I don't think that would be.
It's very, very brassy and very tinny. Like, he uses a lot of.
I mean, it'll be epic. Yeah. It just might be the wrong kind of epic for like a Zelda.
Yeah. It fits Star Wars and it fits all the movies he's done. And he probably would do a great job on Zelda. I just don't know if he'd be.
It's not like I think he'd be bad. But again, it might be like the guy you were just talking about. He's great. Mm-hmm. So it would probably end up being good, but in the context of the film, it'll be safe, not as spectacular as it could be in that moment.
Yeah.
Because it's just kind of taking him out of where his comfort zone should be.
Let's see. Another personal favorite of mine would be Ennio Morricone.
Okay.
But he's more, I don't know, it's very hard to describe his type of music. I think, let's see, I don't want to be wrong on this one.
Oh! Here's a guy I totally forgot about, because the movie I was thinking of with him is a terrible movie, and it makes me upset because it just ruined a lot of things for me with one of my favorite book series as a very young adult, like when I was 20, the Aragon Eldest and whatever, I forget what the third book is. That series was fantastic. One of my all-time favorite book series. And I openly admit that series is not... it's not... The wording in it is very much like for teenagers.
Yeah.
Like in Harry Potter, you could see how like that's written and adults can enjoy that. Aragorn is very much like... it was written by a teenager at the time, so like, it kind of makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
But the story it tells is like really encompassing, and I always felt... could make a good Lord of the Rings type of movie. And they just bombed it with Aragorn so bad. I don't know what they were thinking.
Yeah, really good.
But the music was good. Mm-hmm. Like, they had the perfect guy, and it's Patrick Doyle.
Okay.
And I just realized he did the music in Brave. I see in animated movies, I never pay attention to who did the music. But he's also been involved in the Harry Potter and Thor albums and a whole bunch of other ones.
So, I have a small little list for us to decide on then.
Sure.
So, there's someone that I forgot that I don't know, I'm kicking myself in the head that I forgot this, because he is kind of a video game composer.
Okay, that's okay. We're all video game composers.
Yeah, but he also does movies, so he'd be perfect, in my opinion. But we have Hans Zimmer from Pirates. He does the Pirates Caribbean just as, like, one single idea. We have Michael Giacchino, who's done Star Trek. He's done Star Wars, The Force Awakens, Super 8, Up, Star Trek Beyond. So he's very versatile. And then...
As you list a bunch of sci-fi movies, he's very versatile.
But we have, and then you said Patrick Doyle he did Brave, he did Aragorn. But there's someone that I forgot.
And Harry Potter, and Rise of the Planet of the Apes, and apparently Hamlet.
There's
a bunch of stuff I didn't know he did.
There's Harry Gregson Williams.
What did he do?
He did the entire, or at least he had a hand in doing most of the Metal Gear Solid soundtracks.
Okay.
He did the Sons of Liberty theme. Let's see, he scored Chronicles of Narnia, Man, he's done
that a lot. That had a good score in that.
Yeah, he's known specific, like, in terms of video games, he's known mostly for Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah.
But he's done, let's see if I can find anything else.
Sure. I like that pick.
Yeah. He's done a lot. He's done Shrek. He's done The Rundown, which has a fantastic album or music score to it.
The Rundown. What's that again?
It's got, I don't remember, it's such a long time ago, but it's got The Rock in it. Has a great, like,
theme. Oh, okay. Yeah. That's the one that had The Rock in that one. What's that one guy's name? I always remember him as Stifler, but it's not. I can't believe I don't remember his name. Okay, yeah, I remember that movie.
Yeah.
That was all right. That was one of The Rock's first movies.
Then we've got, he has also done X-Men Wolverine, Cowboys and Aliens, Total Recall,
Martian.
Like,
I guess, you know, narrowed down the list, I think he's definitely one of the finalists.
Yeah.
I still really like Patrick Doyle. I know that I'm looking at more of the stuff he's done.
So it's between Harry Gregson-Williams and Patrick Doyle then.
Yeah, I mean, or they could just both do it.
Yeah, they could collab on that. That'd be.
Those are two really big names.
Yeah.
To be usually with the collab, it's like a big name, and then some guys that aren't as well known. But hey, this is Zelda, baby.
Yeah, this is our dream.
Go all out. Idea. All out. You know what? And ending credits make it John Williams just because. Just because. Then you could throw some trumpets in there. That's okay.
Yeah. Okay, so we've got our composer. We've got what kind of the movie it should be. Now here's the big part.
Oh, my actors. God. Oh, no. Will Smith is Link.
Will Smith is Link and David.
No, I'm sorry. No, Will Smith's son is Link. That's Child Link.
Dave Chappelle is Zelda.
Oh, boy. The Rock is the king. Okay, so some more serious responses. The thing is, I'm not saying any of those people are bad actors. In fact, I actually think The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, is actually slowly becoming pretty decent at this acting stuff.
Yeah, I mean, he's Adam and whatever.
He's more for comedies, but still, like, he's actually getting pretty good at it. I'm surprised. I guess I shouldn't be, because he did a really good job acting as The Rock all those years in WWE. Like, that is an act, so he did a pretty good job of it. Should we just start with the biggest roles?
Yeah, so who do we want for Link?
That's so tough. I'm trying to think back.
Now,
are we thinking Child Link, or are we going adult?
Let's go Adult Link.
Let's go Adult, okay. Because, like, this series does take, like, it could even be an older, like, it doesn't have to be, like, a teenager.
Shia LaBeouf.
See, I don't hate him, I just don't think he'd be a good Link.
Yeah, I don't think he's a good actor, but, I mean, he's a great actor.
I think he's a good typecast actor.
Yeah.
Certain roles, like, what he did in Holes, that was a really good, but, like.
That was also, like, a decade ago.
I know, but, like, it kind of fit, like, the kind of acting he's good at.
Yeah.
Indiana Jones did not fit the kind of action he's good at.
Well, Indiana Jones 4 should have happened, period.
Anyways, and I think, how are they making another Indiana Jones? Oh my god.
Yep.
The thing is, I'm going to watch it. I'm going to be there day one because I love Indiana Jones that much. It's just, Harrison Ford is awesome, but.
I'm thinking.
Oh, Harrison Ford is Link! No.
Who would look good as Link? Like, you think, and then he's like, yeah, he like, looks like Link.
Like, who kind of gives you that Link look, but then.
I'm kind of thinking Liam Hemsworth.
Liam, okay.
As like
me, he's got the face.
Yeah.
I mean, they can do whatever with his hair. I'm not worried about that. But like, he might be a little too buff.
He just has to thin down. That's all.
Well, I mean, like, he's not gonna thin down. Look at the role he plays. He's not gonna thin down. He has to stay buff.
Mm-hmm.
For as long as that role exists, he has to stay buff. But, yeah, like his young, like, I'm looking at some picture of when he was younger, not quite as buffed up. Like, that's a really good looking Link.
Yeah.
And he's a good actor. Mm-hmm. But man, there's got to be more. I'm trying to think of some movies because I don't always remember the actors' names, but I can just look them up quick.
You know who? Did you ever see Kingsman?
Oh, Kingsman is good.
The main guy from that, Taron Egerton, I think.
Let me look here. The main guy.
He should be on like the front of the poster. Sorry, I'm thinking Colin, not Colin Firth, but
yeah, no, I know you're not thinking of him.
The guy that plays Eggsy in the movie.
That plays who? Oh, Eggsy, mm-hmm. Alex Nikoloff. That's the person it has listed on IMDb. Who is apparently a nobody. He's only been in 3 movies.
Whoever the kid is.
The kid. Yeah. That might be the kid. I think that was one of his first.
That's his younger.
Oh, that's his younger self.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Taron Egerton is Eggsy.
Oh, Taron Egerton. Okay. Yeah, he did an awesome job in Kingsman. But yeah. What other stuff has he done? He's Eddie the Eagle. I haven't seen that one yet.
Forgot that he was in that movie. He's relatively new.
Yeah, I'm looking at his old stuff. Kingsman is like his big. Yeah, Kingsman is like the biggest movie he's done so far. Well, and he's in the next Kingsman.
Yeah.
Which and I didn't even know there was another Kingsman coming, so that just excites me even more.
He's like, in a new Robin Hood.
New Robin Hood Origins. Is he Robin Hood?
Yep.
Yeah.
So I think he could be pretty good.
I love Robin Hood. I hope that movie doesn't suck like the last one did with what's his name?
I know who you're thinking of.
Russell Crowe.
Yeah.
Like I like Russell Crowe. It was just not a good story. I just did not like that take on Robin Hood. All right, anyways.
We don't want to go like too old. We don't like Chris Pratt for like Link.
And Chris Pratt's got some nice talent. You know, he could do serious, but what kind of Link do we want? Do we want him to have a sense of humor?
I mean, yeah, but like not to the point where
what's this kind of film? Like are we having like a sarcastic hero? Or like a dead serious hero, like in Lord of the Rings or something.
I'm thinking somewhere in between, like not to the point where it's like the CDI Link, but not to the point where this is like Christian Bale's Batman Link. So like somewhere in between where he could be serious but also like sarcastic and funny.
It's funny you went with like a personality that's considered terrible to like. What many people consider one of the best Batmans of all time.
I
know the fact you picked him told me you don't like that Batman, but a vast majority of the people out there think that's one of the best Batmans. So
we'll say super serious. We don't want a super serious Link. We don't want a super silly Link. We want somewhere in between.
And now that you said like Batman, I'm trying to think of like, maybe a better comparison would almost be like what they always make the personality of James Bond.
Yeah.
Like, it's serious, but there's some jokes and some stuff in there.
But we don't want him, like, super suave Link. Like.
Well, no, not suave. Not the suave way. Like, that's a total Bond thing to be suave. Like, not that. He doesn't need to be, you know, I'm not even going to say the word. I'm just going to leave it alone. Just a ladies' man.
We've got Liam Hemsworth and Taron Egerton. And I'm leaning more towards that last one.
Yeah, let's just lock in Taron Egerton. Okay. I like that pick.
Okay, so how about for Zelda?
Oh, that's tough. There was someone I was just thinking of. Oh, no. I can't pick her because that's just a personal thing.
Who?
Alicia Cuthbert.
Yeah, I mean, I could see her being...
She has the look... Clearly, the look that would totally fit what Zelda looks like. She's just an okay actress, though.
Yeah.
She's not terrible. She is really good. There's this new show that I'm watching that I had never heard of before. And I still don't remember the name of it because I've only seen like 3 episodes of it. But it's like she was with this guy and left him at the altar. And it's a total comedy show. And she's really, really funny in it. Like... I know she's in The Ranch, and I just the Ranch is just okay. but this series, other series, is just hilarious, and she's a big reason it's funny. But it's like, When you think of her, you just think she's pretty.
Yeah.
And I guess when I was younger, I always kind of imagined that her as Princess Zelda. So again, please tell me you have a better pick than that, because that.
I can't get off it. Younger actors and actresses.
So. I know, and that's why I picture, like, she's not too old yet.
Yeah. Maybe let's not focus on hair color for a second.
Well, yeah, I didn't pick it actually with hair color.
How about Sophie Turner?
Sophie Turner.
She's from Game of Thrones. She's Sansa Stark.
Okay, yep, obviously. I feel bad. I'm such a big Game of Thrones fan. I don't know the name of any of the actors. Cool. Yeah, that's a nice solid pick. She definitely has like the composure, the stature. Yeah.
I had someone else in mind, but I completely blanked.
I know.
You saw Suicide Squad, right?
Yeah.
The one who played Enchantress, Cara Del.
Oh God! I was gonna say, thank God you didn't say the one who played Harley Quinn.
No.
Because I was gonna be like, I mean, she maybe. I guess I need to see her do something besides Harley Quinn. Which I'm sure she's done something besides Harley Quinn. But
Cara Delevingne. I'm gonna butcher that anyways.
Karen.
But her. No, I'm not like. She was just someone that I had in my mind.
Sure.
But I don't know.
See, and I had someone besides Alicia Cuthbert. I'm trying to remember who it is.
What was she in?
See, part of me wants to say Scarlett Johansson, but I think she's too old now.
Yeah, she'd be too old to play.
Armin. Yeah, because of the age of Arlene, I just think she's too old. I mean, she still looks young. She still looks gorgeous, but and she's a good actress. But it, you know, if this was her like 5 years ago, I think it would be fine. Mm-hmm. But
plus, we want to lock these down for like long term.
Yeah, so like this movies. Isn't. Yeah. So like, I don't want her to be too. Like, I think she'd fit for one movie, but it wouldn't be a series of movies.
Yeah.
That sucks too, because she's such a good actress. Oh, man. And I didn't pick her because she's blonde. I don't know what this blonde theme is. I mean, because obviously Princess Zelda's blonde, but that's not. Because you could always dye hair colors, or this Zelda could just not be blonde. It's not a big deal.
Yeah.
Because there are brown hair Zeldas. So, like, they're pink haired Links. It is what it is. Man, I'm trying to think that there was someone that, when we were talking about Link, I was thinking of would be a perfect match for that guy.
Anna Kendrick?
Who's that?
She's the one in Pitch Perfect. The brunette.
Anna Kendrick. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. Yeah, that one?
She might work.
She might work. She's a year older than me. But she looks young, obviously. She looks really young.
We can't. Somehow we forgot about the person who's made for this
role. Ooh, oh, okay.
Zelda Williams.
Oh, yeah, Zelda Williams.
The daughter of Robin Williams.
The daughter of Robin Williams. The thing is like, I don't know if she could really act.
No, I know.
That's the problem. Like, she has been in some movies. But, like, a lot of it was when she was, like, a little kid.
Well, and a lot of the movies that she was in are... They were either younger, or they're animated films, or they're like really short films.
Yeah.
So like, she was in The Legend of Korra.
She's in Ninja Turtles, but she's just a voice.
Yeah, she was in the show, I think.
Yeah, the TV series. She was Mona Lisa, the voice of Mona Lisa.
So we don't know.
So like, I'm looking at her resume of movies. Like, nothing really looks that great until, except for when she was younger, and she was just playing a kid. So
we're looking at Sophie Turner, Anna Kendrick, and Kara, whatever her last name is. Do you have anyone else?
I think we gotta go with Sophie Turner. Just based on that list. I mean, I'm sure there's some better options out there. I just keep drawing blanks.
Okay. All right. So
I'm really mad I couldn't remember the one that I really was thinking of. For Ganondorf.
Eddie Murphy,
especially if you want a little comic relief with your, Ganondorf, which isn't necessarily a bad thing per se, an evil guy that's funny, that you don't actually want to die, like hey, look in the Wind Waker, you don't actually want him to die. He's not actually that terrible, but again, he doesn't know how to do what he wants without being terrible. let me just kidnap every blind girl in the world.
There's an obvious pick, which is Dwayne Johnson.
Dwayne Johnson would be a pretty good, because he's got the bulk, so he's got the look. Yeah. And he could totally pull off, like, a serious enough villain that can be conflicted, if we want him to be a little conflicted.
Yeah. How about Danny DeVito?
It's just too short. Yeah, it's just too short. I mean, there's nothing against, like, I think he's a great actor. Just too short for this kind of role.
Yeah.
Like I feel like if it's going to be Gandalf, and I know they could do, like, camera trickery and make people as big as they want, but it feels like, when I think Gandalf, it feels like someone who's big, bulky, really good actor who could pull off, like, a dark and confusing character that...
What about... He's not big or bulky, but what about Jack Nicholson?
Jack Nicholson. That's an interesting choice.
He was the Joker in the first in Tim Burton's Batman.
Oh, yeah. I know. Who doesn't know who Jack Nicholson is?
I think he could play a pretty menacing villain.
Yeah, and Man, I like his... Well, when I think of him as Gandalf, I think of him the personality he had in The Departed.
Yeah.
Like that kind of villain.
Mm-hmm.
Granted, that also was a very intelligent villain. Questionable whether Gandalf's that intelligent, but this is a new series. He could be whatever we want to be. I do like that. I do question longevity.
Yeah. What about Liam Neeson?
Liam Neeson. Is he another one we have to worry about longevity with? Let me see. How
no, he's...
Oh, he's not too bad. Well, right now he's in his 70s? 74?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, that's something you might have to worry about longevity with. I mean, not as bad as Jack Nicholson. Man, Jack Nicholson's ancient.
That's true.
Like, he was born in 1937. I mean, he's lucky to still be around right now.
I mean, how old is...
See, I think if this was, like, Liam Neeson at the time that Star Wars Episode 1 came out, that would be fine.
Nicolas Cage.
Nicolas Cage? See,
Nicolas Cage needs to be in every movie.
The thing is, I like Nicolas Cage. I just think he hit, like, he blew all his money, right? So he was just taking every single role he could. And the problem with that is that the movie sucked. So it didn't matter if he was any good. Like, just look at some of the movies like he's known for. Like, these are some good movies, man. Like, he just blew all his money. Like,
yeah, I mean, I'm looking at other actors too that sound like they would be great. Like, Ben Kingsley might make a great... He makes a great villain, but he's 72 also.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Like, a lot of the villains we think of are people that are old because they're what we grew up with as villains.
Yeah. I mean, you could... I don't...
That's why I said, like... This is going to sound like, really bad. Is The Rock going to win by default? Because we can't...
No, but this is going to sound really bad, because if we're sticking with, like, younger characters, I don't want to make this, like, a teenage movie. Like, it's all about...
Well, and, like, the villain, the Ganondorf's always traditionally come across me as older than like, Zelda.
But I'm also thinking, and like, not because it is going to sound racist. I don't mean it to sound racist, but it kind of does.
You racist.
I'm thinking Adam Driver, because he has, like, the nose of Ganondorf, and he looks like him. He's just young. He's Kylo Ren in the new...
Yeah, yeah, I know. I have IMDb, yeah. Yeah, he kind of looks like him. And he's young.
Yeah.
I mean, he could be around for all the movies.
Yeah, we'll toss him on there.
It's a possibility. Not quite sure of his acting skills per se. He was fine in The Force Awakens.
We didn't see that much of him.
Yeah, that's the thing. I didn't see enough. Like, what I saw of him kind of was annoying, but then it was more of the script than him. I don't really... I didn't come away thinking, man, he did a bad job. It's just like, I need to see some more of you to really figure out your character. Because right now you kind of seem like a whiny brat. You don't seem like... Like, I want my next Darth Vader, and you just don't seem like that. By the way, I can't wait for the new movie just because it's going to have Darth Vader. Like, oh, I'm so pumped. When I went to see Doctor Strange, They had a trailer for it that I hadn't seen yet because I've been kind of avoiding the new Star Wars trailers. And yeah. when it ended with the breathing of Darth Vader, I just, like, was geeking out so hardcore. Like, the movie's probably not even going to be that great, but it's got Darth Vader, so I'm there.
Yeah.
Oh, anyways. So what do we have right now for choices for Ganondorf?
We've got Dwayne Johnson, Jack Nicholson, Ben Kingsley, and Adam Driver. Okay.
I think we're just going to have to take Nicholson off. I think really? He'd be really good. Like, the thing is, I think he, out of all the choices, he's the best choice. But then it's not gonna be a franchise.
Well, but let's think about this realistically or unrealistically too, because we picked two giant composers and we're making them.
Well, if we're thinking unrealistically, he's gonna live forever. Then it's Jack Nicholson.
Yeah. So let's.
All right, Jack Nicholson it is then.
Jack Nicholson.
Or take Jack Nicholson and put him in The Rock's body. If we're gonna be really imaginative, no, Jack Nicholson. Okay, I can get behind that.
So who else needs to be in this movie?
Well, you figure. We got the sages. Some sort of sages, and so, they usually can play as big a role or smaller role as we want.
So, are we gonna go with like traditional Ocarina of Time sages, or like Ruto and Darunia? Because if we're doing Darunia, then that's
Dwayne Johnson. Well, it's clearly Dwayne Johnson. There's just no. I think we should go. Well, when I think back on the sages, usually there's like one from every race.
Yeah,
and then.
So we can do Goron Sage, one or Goron Sage.
Yeah, the Goron Sage is Dwayne Johnson. There's
we don't know his name.
It doesn't matter. There's no doubt. He looks like a Goron. He is a decent enough actor to pull off that role.
Yeah.
So like, who would be like? It's looking at what races do we want? Well, Zoras, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
I got the Zora. See, it feels like a Zora one should be female.
Yeah, just to balance it out.
Plus, like, I think it's always, like, when it's been when one, it's always been female.
Yeah. I mean, we can go default with Jennifer Lawrence.
We could.
That could be
our fallback. Jennifer Lawrence for everything. Sure, that's fine. Jennifer Lawrence sounds like it would be a good... And then, let me see. Feels like we need, like, a foresty sage. Doesn't need to be Kokiri, but...
I'm thinking for King. You've seen Independence Day, right? Oh,
who hasn't?
The first one. The president, Bill Pullman. I think he might make a good king. He's got that beard.
Does he? Let me see.
Yeah.
I haven't actually checked on him. I mean, I know he was in the new, you know, the new one, which I... Oh, yeah. Look at that. Yeah, yeah, looks like a king to me. He almost looks like... Sadly, he kind of reminds me of Robin Williams. But anyways. I like him. And he's not, like, a fantastic actor. But very... he's good enough for the short scenes. Like, every actor we put in doesn't have to be, like, a superstar. He's kind of, like, the perfect... Like, for small roles.
So just for placeholder names, I'm going to put the Goron Sages, Darunia, and then our Zora Sage.
So you want to talk about racism. Our whole cast is white.
Well, Dwayne Johnson is
not. But he's like as white as you can get for what he is.
So who else could we throw in there then to make this a culturally appropriate...
I know, and I keep thinking, like, it's hard, because most of the characters in Zelda are white.
We need John
Boyega. Maybe we have a sage from the Gerudo tribe.
Yeah. I'm thinking, though, like, I want... Ooh, he's about as old as our Link in Zelda.
Who?
The guy who played Finn in Star Wars.
Oh, God, what's his name?
John Boyega. Yeah.
Okay.
Not because he's black.
I was gonna be like, I suddenly mentioned race, and you suddenly cast a black guy.
But because he's a really good actor, and we've got that longevity then with Ganondorf.
Yeah, no, he's a pretty good actor. He's gonna be in the new Pacific Rim. Nice.
We haven't seen him play a villain role yet, so we could give him. We could be like Marvel and give him.
Yeah,
a
I'm, I'm looking back at his history here. He definitely has not done a villain per se. He's been a conflicted murder person, but that not necessarily a, an evil guy. And he was apparently in Law and Order in the UK.
So do we want to toss him in as our Ganondorf or leave Jack Nicholson and
put him in? Well, I feel like Jack Nicholson is just too perfect for the role. Like, the only thing that turned me off is just because he's old. But,
Nate, we forgot Navi.
Oh, we're going to put Navi in this thing? The only person that goes to mind, because she's done a fairy before, is who played Tinkerbell and Hook?
Oh, man.
I can't think of her name now. She actually is like a really famous actress.
I feel like I know who it is, but I don't want to be wrong.
Julia Roberts.
Why would you want her?
I don't know. I liked her as Tinkerbell, and she's annoying. And that's what Navi is. Is annoying little fairy that you do not even want to talk to.
So Julia Roberts is our annoying fairy.
Yes. I don't know why we're including a fairy. I hate fairies. Like I don't hate fairies. I hate the way Zelda uses fairies. But I guess if we have to have fairy as like his companion character, fine.
Do we want to... If we're going to make this our perfect movie, what about Midna? I'd like to see her in the movie
Imp
somewhere.
Imp or full version?
Both. It'd probably be
CGI Imp. Okay.
Imp.
Voiced by the person who ends up being the full body. Oh, jeez. That's someone where I hate bringing race in again. It feels like it should be a black woman.
No. Well, like, it'd have to be...
And I'm just thinking of the look of her more darker toned skin. I mean, granted, you could... I mean, white people, you could just paint them.
That's even more
I know.
Racist.
Welcome to the new America.
I'm trying to think of someone. Here's my problem is that I'm trying to think of someone that's like seductive and
sure,
and like teasy, but and so like I'm instinctively I go to Jada Pinkett Smith.
Who is that again?
Or Rosaria Dawson.
Who's that person that I'm? Who am I thinking of? A couple movie I know she's in. See, I was almost thinking of Zoe Saldana, Dana.
Ooh.
Because she's kind of, in the role she's been, she's kind of got that, like, seductive, sarcastic.
Yeah, we could get...
But still, like, a badass kind of vibe.
Yeah, Zoe Saldana.
Totally forgot about her. I remember Guardians of the Galaxy, and I was like, ooh, that kind of reminded me of, like, a Midnight kind of character.
Yeah.
A little bit. I mean, obviously coming from, you know, an evil side instead of actually being good the whole time. But she was also she was also in Avatar. Did a good job. And Star Trek, of course.
So we have three actresses for Midna. We've got Jaden Pinkett Smith, Rosaria Dawson, and Zoe.
I say we just throw them in a ring and see who lives. Those are all really good choices.
Because Jaden Pinkett Smith plays a really good villain, but like not necessarily always a villain. And I'm just a big fan of Rosaria Dawson, so that's more of my preference.
There's nothing wrong with that. Hey, I threw out Alicia Cuthbert, who has no business really being in a Zelda film, just because I'm a fan. And I do like Rosaria Dawson a lot. Like, there has not been a role she has played I do not like. Yeah. I mean, literally, like, wasn't she in, like, Sin City? I feel like she was...
The most recent role, she's in Daredevil.
Well, yeah, she's in the Daredevil and Jessica Jones and the new one, Luke Cage. She's really, like, Luke Cage is the one she's really going to be involved in now, I think, based on how... Yep. I won't spoil people for anyone who hasn't watched Luke Cage yet, but she's definitely going to be more in that one. She was introduced in Daredevil, though. She was also.
Have you watched The Flash?
Oh, I love The Flash.
I'd like to see Candace Patton.
Really?
There. Yeah. I'd like to see Iris playing Midna.
It's funny. She's usually the character people don't like. I don't actually think she's that bad. Like, some people compare her to the person who plays Laurel on Arrow, and I'm like, no, Laurel is way worse. The thing is, I didn't think Laurel was that bad as other people did, but no. I think Candace does a lot better job. Oh my gosh.
I forgot about Grant Gustin. He could have been our link.
Grant Gustin.
He's Barry
Allen. Oh yeah, Barry Allen, duh. It's funny. Not once watching the show that I ever asked myself, who is that guy playing Flash? I'm just like, it's just Barry Allen. It's just who he is. I don't have to wonder.
Yeah. I'd like him as Link. So, oh man, now I'm conflicted.
The thing is, I don't know. Like, I like his personality on Flash. Obviously, I feel like that personality is a good one for Link, but... Oh. Thing is, that's like the only thing he's done that's good.
Yeah, let's lock in who we have then. I won't focus on that. But I'm liking...
If anything else, this is just another shout-out that they should have made him Flash in the movies.
Ugh. What about this? What if we made Sophie Turner our Midna and put Candace Patton as our Zelda?
Go the other way around.
Yeah. What if we did that? I'd like that.
Yeah, that... You know what? I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. So... I think that can work.
So Candace Patton is
just slipping in that Candace Patton. Actually, I think she'd be an excellent Zelda, to be honest.
Yeah,
I think she'd fit that role well.
So we've got. Is there anyone else that's? I totally forgot.
Candace Patton was on Young and the Restless back in the day. Holy crap! I totally forgot she was on that. I used to watch all the time with my mom. Yes, I was that.
There
guy.
Is one role that we need to fill in.
Though, oh, what's that?
That I already have. This is already picked
up.
Oh,
no.
And
not what is it?
We have the Great Deku Tree. He's everywhere. But he's voiced by, can you guess? Someone with a deep,
powerful, ancient kind of sounding voice. But not like, you know. Well, obviously, it's powerful, so obviously, you know, not like you're dying. Because that's what I've always imagined his voice is, like, deep and just booming. Not like the grandma-style voice that you get in Pocahontas.
You
want to
know?
Sure.
I'd say James
Earl Jones. Yeah, in his heyday.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's still got it now, but...
I mean, he's voicing him again in Rogue One, so obviously he's still
yeah, but there's a lot of trickery they can do if his voice... Because, like, he's got to sound, like, exactly the same. And if he's not exactly the same, they'll do some voice alterations to fix it.
Either him...
it's hard to argue with James Earl Jones, though. He's so... Yeah. Like, you think of James Earl Jones, his voice is, like, perfect for it.
It's iconic.
Oh yeah, I know that's the thing. Like, look at all. I mean, he's Mufasa and Darth Vader and.
Oh. If he was still alive, I'd say someone like Christopher Lee.
Oh.
I'd love to have Christopher Lee.
Oh, you gotta tell me if he was still alive, my link would have been Heath Ledger. So. I was so mad that he didn't. I mean, not just because of what he did with the Joker. Like, I loved him in A Knight's Tale. Like, I feel like he's got the range that I don't know what his age would have been like, but anyways.
Or we could make Eddie Murphy our Great Deku Tree. Or Chris Rock.
Oh my gosh. If we're gonna have I'm trying to think. I mean, I feel like if we're gonna have them, it feels like we should have like a new character that's like this sarcastic MF-er that just keeps popping up randomly throughout the game. That isn't the old man, but kind of fills that old man role where he just kind of appears, like when you need, like when he needs guidance or when he's confused, and you just a lot of mystery surrounding him, and like he always ends with like a one liner and just leaves Link totally confused.
No, here we go. We can explore the origin of Nate's of Link's parents in this movie.
Oh, there we go. Revisit the fan topic
Link's
idea.
Link's dad.
There, that could work. Link's dad.
Who are we going to make Link's dad?
Link's dad. Oh my gosh.
Steve Buscemi.
Steve? Oh my god. Oh my god. That'd be kind of. I mean, he's a good actor. I just cannot foresee the actor we picked for Link coming from him.
What about Ewan McGregor? What about
Obi-Wan Kenobi? Oh man, it's a good choice. Definitely pretty.
Or Kiefer Sutherland.
Kiefer Sutherland. I like Kiefer Sutherland.
He could be a good Link's dad.
Oh man. Trying to think of somebody else. You know, I think I like Kiefer Sutherland. I think we should go with him for Link's dad.
Okay. Who's going to be Link's mom?
See, that's the tough one. Let me think. All the people I wanted to be Zelda but were too old.
You said Scarlett
Johansson. Scarlett Johansson. I mean, that would explain where his boyish beauty comes from. Like, all of it. No, that's not true.
Link's mom being Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah, that's fine with me. Especially, like, she's a good actress, but yeah, you know what? I wanted to fit her in a role before, and this, like, if it's gonna be about his parents, like the origin stories, like that feels like a good role, a nice strong role. But that also means we probably need to have a child Link that appears in some sort of flashbacks or something.
Yeah.
Especially if it's an origin for parents, because it's gonna be probably starting out, maybe even before Link is born.
Who is that kid in Iron Man 3?
Kid. Oh, the one that's in that.
The young one.
That's in that. That sits in that thing with the armor.
Yeah.
Oh. Let me look here.
Ty Simpkins.
Ty, is that his name? Ty Simpkins? Is he too old now? Let me see.
No, he's. I don't think he is.
Of course, his biography is totally incomplete. It's probably like the only role he's done that matters. He's in Jurassic World.
Yeah, he was.
Oh yeah, he was that kid, wasn't he?
He'd be the perfect age.
Yeah, that could work. Cause like for baby, they could just do anyone, just random baby. Yeah. Then like if you're gonna show growing up over some sequences, I feel like maybe there should almost be a go between though.
I'd say the guy that.
And that's hard because like the go between is gonna be someone who's really really young. So.
I mean, between like baby and like young.
Yeah, like kind of. Or like kind of like yeah, the baby is what it is, and then you have, like someone between like the baby and like Ty, because I feel like you got to show baby, and then you got to show like the 4 year old just kind of learning to do things like with his father or something, and then like. And then you got Ty coming in, showing off like the traditional young Link we all know.
I don't think that the 4 year old or whatever Link would be that important to like cast.
It'd be more of a like it's really going to be in there for like a scene or two, but still feels like this is the primary character in the whole series that's going to keep growing as we go.
Yeah, but we only did him for like 5 seconds for like one or two.
Yeah,
scenes.
Ty Simpkins would probably be in there for at least 20 or so minutes of the movie.
Yeah, he'd be the introduction Link.
Yeah, that's fine. I guess we can not worry about that. That's just me being particular. Like, okay, if we're gonna watch Link growing up, who's gonna be him in all these different stages? Like, who's gonna be the 18-year-old one? Etc.
So I think we'll cut it off at young Link then. Because we've got a large cast.
Well, it's going to be a large cast. A large cast that realistically will never happen.
So let's go over what we have. So we've got... The film's going to be about its own... It's going to be its own thing. So we're not worrying about it adhering to a specific game. We didn't flesh out a story because that's not really as important as what we're talking about right now. But basically, with our characters, we've confirmed it's like
an origin story for Link and his like parents, kind of.
Yeah, and for like all the characters,
because this is like the first movie in what's going to be a series, so it makes sense to have some origin stuff.
Yeah, and so then you've got the composers are Harry Gregson-Williams and Patrick Doyle working together.
Dream team.
We've got Link as Taron Egerton, Zelda is Candace Patton, Ganondorf is Jack Nicholson, which is beautiful. I love that choice. Darunia as Dwayne Johnson. Ruto is Jennifer Lawrence. The King is Bill Pullman. Your annoying fairy is Julia yes. Roberts. Minna is Sophie Turner. The Great Deku Tree is James Earl Jones. Link's dad is Kiefer Sutherland. Link's mom is Scarlett Johansson, and Young Link is Ty Simpkins. That's a pretty stellar.
That's what I would say. Like that would never happen. Or if it did, it'd be like one of those, like one of those movies. That it sounds like it should be good because they threw like 50 big name actors together, and it's just the worst movie ever because they're trying to give them all equal screen time, and it just bombs. Yeah. They don't really worry about creating a good story. Oh, they always do that with those stupid chick flicks. I'm like, oh my god, okay. It should be good, but it's too much. Unless you have like a 5-hour movie, there's just not enough screen time.
Yeah, it's got a lot of all of these are like top paid or like closer to being very expensive actors.
Yeah, well,
especially pulling in like
I feel. Well, Scarlett see, I Johansson. Feel like for the first movie, it would actually work okay with her because I feel like she would have a big role in this first movie. Like it,
yeah. For like maybe,
I
like
mean, maybe even like half the movie, she would be like the and like it's one of those where even after you get past like her life, you know, and you're moving more into Link and what he's starting to become, mm-hmm. It's still like you can still have the flashback memories to stuff he learns from her and his dad. Mm-hmm. like that stuff could still exist as the series goes on, but like this first movie, I could see her doing because she would have a bit like she would have a pretty big role in the first movie,
yeah.
You know, whether or not she'd want to sign on for multiple just for some flashback moments beats me. But
I like our picks for Link, Zelda, and
Ganondorf.
Oh,
yeah. I think those are awesome really picks, and they have to exist. Mm-hmm. And one thing I like about the Ty Simpkins, too, for the young Link is if in the future there's a time travel sequence, he would still be okay as young Link for possibly movie 2 if it gets explored.
Yeah.
But you can't really go much beyond that because then he's going to start getting too old. But I feel like if for some reason that gets explored after the origin story where they start getting into some time travel, that at least you have that option of a pretty decent actor who's going to look good as young Link and still have the older Link, you know, be part of it, you know, if they do the 7-year thing or if they do, you know, whatever they want to do. You know, heck, they could have the whole second movie just be about Young Link for some reason. So I really like our choice for Young Link and the older Link. Those are perfect to me. It just opens the door.
We did
I think we did good. You know, the Ganondorf. It's just so perfect. This needs to be 20 years ago.
At this point,
20 years ago, where I don't have to worry about him not being alive for the second film.
At this point, any Ganondorf they pick will not live up to our dream Ganondorf.
Well,
like, if they ever do a film or an animation.
Oh, yeah, that's the problem with this dream scenario. If they do a film, because you know it's going to be a bunch. It's going to be mostly a bunch of people we probably haven't heard of much or have only done, TV shows or something. And that's fine. That doesn't mean it can't be good. Like, I never heard of most of the people that are in The Flash before The Flash happened. And it ends up being really, really good. So it's like, it doesn't mean it's not going to be good. It's just hard to imagine it being as good. Like if they have a great Deku Tree in a TV series and it's not James Earl Jones, they just better just not have him talk.
Yeah.
Just a silent Deku Tree. Like, have him just die. Just die right away. Oh.
Or reference, just like a slight name reference.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Or they have like James Earl Jones actually do it for some odd reason. They decide that he's worth paying the money for a character who's going to die. And then as like they're doing the Ocarina of Time and as like he's in the tree, like off in the corner, there's like a little Darth Vader helmet. Just hidden, a little reference. Because hey, they throw references to Mario and Zelda. Come on now.
That's true.
Okay.
I'd love it if this was, like, bought and paid for by Disney. And then they'd have all the money.
Plus, they'd have all the IP use. They wouldn't have to pay extra for.
Oh, my gosh.
Like, you could throw in a Darth Vader mask and not have to pay someone to do that. It's Majora's Mask with Darth Vader mask. You become Vader. Makes no sense. Doesn't have to make sense. It's Majora's Mask.
That scenario... took a lot
of time. Oh, I knew it was going to take a long time. Like, trying to come up with people for roles. Ugh.
We should just, like, we can make that, do the whole, like, long video. But
yeah, I feel like that's going to be, like, a separate podcast. Because, well. I mean, yeah. I'm sure all you guys love it. Like, maybe we'll release, like, an audio only of the full 2 hours. Because I know some people, like, listen to this at their gyms and stuff, but.
Yeah. So we'll release the audio, like, all at once. But the video will probably be two separate videos. Mostly for uploading troubles, too, and rendering troubles.
Right.
Make it easier on us. But that way, you guys will have two things to look forward to.
I don't want to see the size of this video file when we're done.
Yeah, I'm.
Thank God I didn't record with my phone, because it would have been something like 30 gigs. So.
Yep.
Oh boy.
But I think that about does it. We've got our lineup for the perfect Zelda film never happen.
Feel free, by the way, to go down in the comments and totally destroy our picks. And, like, show us an even better one. Because, you know what? I have seen lineups picked for Zelda movies in the past, especially once that Netflix series rumor went around. Or report or whatever. I saw everyone picking their stuff. And we as a staff kind of jokingly picked one that admittedly was not very good. This list is way better. But it's just... This is awesome. This is just awesome. This was a lot of fun. I hope I think what we'll do is we'll post this one separate. Like, it's its own thing. And I think it's going to get, like, a huge lot of conversation, a lot of debate going. Because this is just a fun thing.
And I'll try to post pictures of each person as we name them.
Just hear me type it off. I'm like, who is that exactly? I can't quite remember. I recognize faces. That was Barry Allen? That was the Flash? Yep. What? Yeah. Oh, man.
Sounds good.
Oh, yeah. Two-man podcast for the win.
I'm not editing this until...
That's the way you look at it. Yeah, we're editing tomorrow. Don't worry about it today. All right, well, thanks everyone for listening. This has been a fun little podcast. A little different. I haven't checked my phone. I'm sure I'm getting yelled at for being too loud.
just keep in mind, next week we're eating peppers and reciting
Next week we're dying. So. Next week
we're going to be in pain. This was the calm.
This is the calm? Oh, God. Oh, God.
At least we didn't have any, like, serious arguments, though. Like, we didn't, like, yell at each
other. I thought about it at one point on one of your picks, but that person ended up not becoming the one, so I was okay. I let it go. I learned to let it go. The only thing I ever learned from Frozen. Let it go.
Well, thank you for that. So... Well, thank you guys for listening and bearing through these two videos or this one
audio
podcast. We will see
catch you guys next week. Adios.